very good morning and Jai Hind children. Welcome to biology class. Children, as you know that today we are going to start a new chapter of bio, that is chapter 8, cell structure and function. Okay, before the starting this chapter, let me first show you the syllabus of term 2 annual, that what all chapter you have to study. Okay, so I'll first share the syllabus with you. So this is your syllabus, children. We have already covered the term 1 syllabus, half yearly syllabus. Now we are moving ahead with the annual syllabus. So the annual syllabus consists of 3 chapters. So first is cell structure and function, that is chapter 8. Then we have chapter 9, reproduction. Chapter 10, reaching the age of adolescence. So in annual syllabus, we have to study 3 chapters, chapter 8, 9 and 10. Okay, and there are activities also. So we have 3rd, 4th and 5th activity that also we will perform. Alright, so today I am going to start with chapter number 8, that is cell structure and function. Children, this is very interesting chapter. Okay, so in this chapter, as the chapter says, cell, we have also, like every time whenever we are studying biology, we have somewhere or the other came across this term called cell. Okay, but we actually don't know what is the main structure of the cell and what is inside the cell and why this cell is so important. Okay, so today in this chapter, we are going to study all the thing, like from tip to toe, everything about cell. Okay, how, what is the structure of cell, how cell was discovered, what is the basic function of cell. So everything we are going to study today in this chapter, that is cell structure and function. Okay, so children, please open your science book, open chapter number 8, cell structure and function. Okay, so children, we know that our body is made up of a very tiny, smallest unit called cell. Okay, now take for example, take two things. First take a human and take any animal. Okay, take a lion or take a human. We have two things. Okay, let's compare the both. Let's compare what is the similarity between both. So what is the main similarity? First, that both perform locomotion. Dono kya karte hain? Locomotion perform karte hain, matlab dono chal sakte hain. Okay, second, both can give birth to young ones. Okay, humans can also give birth to young ones. Animals can also give birth to young ones. Alright. Humans can reproduce. Animals can also reproduce. Okay. Humans can breed, whereas animal also can breed. Okay. So, if we are talking, if we are comparing the both, humans and animals, both are having basic similar function. Isn't it? Both are having similar function. Both are breathing. Both require food to survive. Both require energy to walk or perform any activity. Both of them can reproduce. Both of them can produce a young one. Okay? So, there is some basic similarity between both of us. Be it human or be it animal. Okay? So there is one basic single thing that is same in both. And that single and smallest thing is called cell. Okay? Cell is the smallest thing that a human, animal, plant, every living organism is made up of. Okay? Now if I am going to compare humans with plants, there is also some similarity. What is the similarity? Both require energy to prepare food. They get the energy from food. Yes, Though plants can prepare food on their own by the process of photosynthesis, we cannot perform the process of photosynthesis. But we also require some energy, and that also we get it from food. Getting my point? So every living organism that is surviving is having some or the other basic similarity. And that basic similarity is because of the pattern of structure, be it like from which the humans, animals, plants and everything is made up of. And that very basic unit from which these living organisms are made is called cell. Getting it? Our body, human body, is made up of trillions of cells. Now what is trillion? Trillion is approximately 100 billion. So our body is made up of 100 billions of cells. And every cell in our body performs some or the other function. So see how complex is a human body. Yes, how complex is a living organism. So we have to, in this chapter, we are going to study about the basic thing about the cell, the structure of the cell, and what all functions does this cell performs. Okay, before that, we will also talk about what is the discovery of cell, like who discovered cell, from where the concept of cell came into existence. All these things also we will talk about in this chapter. Okay, which is chapter number 8, cell structure and function. Children, this is one of my favorite chapter. So please be attentive and listen to me very carefully. There is various thing to understand in human body, in plant body, in living organism. Okay, so if you are interested in knowing what is there inside us, what is, how does plant function, how human body function, so this is the basic chapter. Whenever you are going to higher classes, when you go to higher classes, you will study all these things in much detail. Okay, now in this chapter, as it is just an introduction of the cell, so you will learn the basic thing about the cell. Getting it? So now we know that cell is the basic smallest unit from which our body is made up of. And because of the cell, our body performs different functions. So cell is called basic structural and functional unit of life. Cell is called basic structural and functional unit of life. Okay, so now I'm going to share the PowerPoint along with the PDF of the chapter, and we'll see what all we have to study in this chapter. Okay, so I hope everybody is ready. Now first I'll share the PPT. We'll see what are the topics that are included in this chapter, and then I'll switch to the PDF of the chapter and will make you understand what is there. Okay, so this is the PPT. Okay, so these are the topics that are included in this chapter. So we have to study about discovery of the cell, the cell theory, unicellular and multicellular organism, variations in shapes and sizes of the cell, definitely, structure of the cell, plant and animal cells. Okay, all these things we are going to discuss. So today we will talk about three topics. First three topics, that is discovery of cell, the cell theory, unicellular and multicellular organism. And rest of the topic we will cover in the next class. Okay, so children, get ready. So before that, let me first show you the chapter. So you should also know what is included in this chapter. Just a moment. Okay, so chapter number 8, cell structure and function. So we have to talk about the discovery of cell, okay? Then we'll talk about the cell theory. Then we have unicellular and multicellular organism, variations in shapes and size of the cell, and structure of the cell, and everything we'll talk about the structure. So children, this is very interesting chapter. Please listen to each and everything very carefully, okay? So first we'll start from the discovery of cell, from where the concept of cell came into existence, okay? So first let me start with it. So children, we know that cell is very small. The size of cell is very tiny, so tiny that we cannot see it through our naked eyes. Okay? We cannot see a cell through our naked eyes. Alright? That is why, because we cannot see a cell through our naked eyes, we require certain instrument. Okay? And now we know that to magnify any small thing, we require certain magnifying instrument. Magnifying instrument kya hota hai? Wo instrument jo kisi bhi choti cheez ko enlarge kar de aur usko hum clearly dekh paaye ki uske andar kya present hai. That is magnifying instrument. Okay. So, in science, we know that the magnifying instrument that we use is microscope. Okay. So, we know that I have already discussed with you in the previous classes that who discovered microscope? Antoine Leeuwenhoek, the person or the scientist you can see here in the figure, he is Antoine Leeuwenhoek. He discovered microscope. Okay, so the first figure that you can see, he discovered this type of a microscope earlier. In a very ancient time, he discovers such type of a microscope, which includes lens, sample holder, focus knob, all these things. So he was the person to discover microscope. Okay, but now we have a modern microscope. The figure, the second figure that you can see, this is a modern microscope. It is also present in our school laboratory, so we can also visit there whenever the school is getting reopened. So I'll show you how this microscope functions. Okay, so I have already told you in the chapter previously that how this microscope functions. So we are aware about all these things. Okay, so Antoine Leeuwenhoek discovered microscope, and then it became possible to see the very tiniest and smallest thing that we cannot see through our naked eyes. जो चीजें हम अपनी आंखों से नहीं देख सकते उसके लिए माइक्रोस्कोप बनाया गया था. ओके, सो व्हेन एंटोइन लीवेनहॉक डिस्कवर्ड द माइक्रोस्कोप, देन इट बिकेम पॉसिबल टू सी सच स्मॉलेस्ट थिंग. गेटिंग इट? देन केम द साइंटिस्ट कॉल्ड रॉबर्ट हुक. कैन यू सी द फिगर? ही इज रॉबर्ट हुक. ओके, रॉबर्ट हुक डिस्कवर्ड सेल. How he discovered cell? He took a cork. Can you see the first figure? This is cork. What is cork? Cork is obtained from the bark of tree. Okay? Tree ka jo bark hota hai, usse ye cork milta hai. Theek? Now, what he did, he cut the cork into small slices and he discovered his own microscope. So the microscope that you see here is Robert Hooke's microscope. ये Robert Hooke का microscope है जो Robert Hooke ने discover किया था. तो इसने क्या किया? इस cork को छोटे-छोटे slices में cut कर लिया, and then he tried to observe it under this microscope. Okay. So when he saw under this microscope, he could see such type of figure that you can see here below the cork. Cell in cork, it is written. So here they उसने इस टाइप का कुछ फिगर उस माइक्रोस्कोप के अंदर देखा. ओके, नाउ यू कैन क्लियरली सी वेरियस कंपार्टमेंट्स प्रेजेंट इन दिस फिगर. यस, सो द सिंगल कंपार्टमेंट, एक सिंगल कंपार्टमेंट जो इस डायग्राम में प्रेजेंट है, दैट सिंगल कंपार्टमेंट द रॉबर्ट हुक नेम्ड इट एज सेल. गेटिंग इट? इस पूरे को हम सेल नहीं कह रहे हैं, इस सेल, इस पूरे फिगर में जो एक सिंगल कंपार्टमेंट है, दैट इज कॉल्ड सेल. गेटिंग इट? देयर आर सेवरल कंपार्टमेंट्स प्रेजेंट. ओके, सो द वन सिंगल कंपार्टमेंट इज कॉल्ड सेल. ओके, एंड दे आर नॉट लिविंग सेल्स, दे आर डेड सेल्स, बिकॉज कॉर्क इज डेड इन नेचर. ओके, सो दे आर नॉट लिविंग सेल बट दे आर डेड सेल्स. So Robert Hooke performed, or Robert Hooke saw a dead cell in a cork, and cork we get it from tree, okay? And he observed it under this microscope that he has discovered, okay? Are you getting this point? So by this method, the cell was discovered, okay? But what is the exact structure of the cell? How cell functions? क्या क्या काम करता है वो सेल? दिस वॉज नॉट क्लियर अंटिल 150 ईयर्स. मतलब आफ्टर 150 ईयर्स तक भी ये चीज क्लियर नहीं थी कि एग्जैक्ट सेल का स्ट्रक्चर क्या है और वो कैसे फंक्शन करता है. बट वी वर अवेयर ऑफ द थिंग दैट यस, देयर वॉज समथिंग कॉल्ड सेल which is divided into compartments and many cells are clubbed together to form any organ or organisms. Okay, so this was the discovery of cell, and Robert Hooke discovered cell in year 1665. Okay, he discovered the cell in year 1665. Getting it? So this was about the discovery of cell. The cell was discovered. Okay, let's see what is written in the chapter. So coming back to the chapter, children, discovery of cell. See, you already know that all living things are made up of one or more cells. Yes, for this reason cell is known as the building block of the life. Building block of the life ka kya matlab hota hai ki, see, we know that a living thing like us is made up of cells. Yes. So, because our body is made up of millions of cells, so it is just like a building blocks. जैसे कि building जब बनती है तो उसमें bricks use होते हैं, blocks use होते हैं. तो जब एक-एक block को हम बनाते हैं, तब वो building खड़ी होती है. Yes. So, like in the same way, one single cell, when many cells are combined together, then it forms a living organism. That is why it is called building block of life. Okay, so cell was discovered by Robert Hooke in year 1665. Children, this is very important, you should always remember it. These types of question also come in your competitive exams, so you should always remember that who discovered cell. Robert Hooke discovered cell in year 1665. Okay, he looked at a thin slice of cork, I told you, under the microscope that he had made. So I have shown you the microscope that Robert Hooke has made, and he saw that it was made up of a small block box like structure, that compartments I told you. So in this figure you can see there are various compartments present like this. So in this compartment, the very single cell, like even this highlighter cannot make that a small cell. So the very single cell, very small one compartment is called cell. Okay, the boxes were separated from each other by a partition. He called these boxes cell. So now this small box is called cell. Getting it? What Hooke actually observed was a dead cells in the cork. That also I have told you. So you have seen cork. What is cork? Okay. However, even 150 years after Robert Hooke's discovery, not much was known about the cell until improved microscope with high magnifications were made. जब तक मॉडर्न माइक्रोस्कोप और हाई मैग्नीफाइंग माइक्रोस्कोप नहीं आया, तब तक सेल का स्ट्रक्चर क्या है, उसका फंक्शन क्या है, इसके बारे में हमें पता नहीं था. ओके, सो नाउ बिकॉज नाउ वी आर हैविंग अ वेरी हाइली डिफाइंड माइक्रोस्कोप, वी हैव इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप, वी हैव नॉर्मल कंपाउंड माइक्रोस्कोप, सो नाउ वी कैन ईजिली सी इट. इवन नाउ वी यूज वेरियस डाइज लाइक कलर टू कलर द पर्टिकुलर सेल ताकि हम उसको और क्लियरली देख सकें. ओके, सो ऑल दिस थिंग वॉज द डिस्कवरी ऑफ सेल. ओके, नाउ आफ्टर द डिस्कवरी ऑफ सेल, आफ्टर द सेल केम इन टू एग्जिस्टेंस, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सेल केम इन टू एग्जिस्टेंस, पीपल स्टार्टेड टू डिस्कवर मोर अबाउट द सेल कि वॉट एग्जैक्टली इट सेल, हाउ इट इज मेड अप ऑफ एंड वॉट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सेल. ओके, then in year 1838 two scientists, that is Sladen and Swan, don't remember the complete name, just remember Sladen and Swan, they were the two scientists, they were the two German biologists who put forward the cell theory of life. Okay, they have given few points for the cell theory. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they have given 5 points regarding cell theory. Okay, so I'll show you who is Sladen and Swan first. So this we have talked about. Now see, they are the two person, he is Sladen and Swan. Clear? Dekh rahe ho, can you see the figure? So he is Sladen and Swan. They both gave a cell theory. Okay. In cell theory, they have given several points regarding cell. Okay, so the first point they have told was that the cell is made up of small blocks like a brick. Okay, जैसे कि ये brick है, you can see the brick here. Okay, like a brick. जैसे कि हम ब्रिक यूज करते हैं कोई भी बिल्डिंग या वॉल बनाने में, वैसे एक सिंगल सेल, बहुत सारे सेल्स जब मिलते हैं, देन इट मेक्स अ ऑर्गेनिज्म और अ ऑर्गन. ओके, सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट रिटन इन द थ्योरी. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट पॉइंट हियर इज ऑल लिविंग थिंग्स आर मेड अप ऑफ सेल. जितने भी लिविंग थिंग है, बी इट प्लांट, बी इट एनिमल्स, बी इट माइक्रोब्स, बी इट बैक्टीरिया, फंजाई, वायरसेस, एवरीथिंग, एवरी लिविंग थिंग्स आर मेड अप ऑफ सेल्स. ओके, जस्ट एज अ वॉल इज मेड अप ऑफ ब्रिक, कोई भी वॉल जैसे ब्रिक की बनी होती है, वैसे लिविंग थिंग्स भी सिंगल सेल के बने होते हैं. ओके, हेंस cells are the basic building block of living organism. Okay, that is why cells are called basic building blocks of living organism. Okay, so though all the living organisms are made up of cell, but every cell performs different function. Okay, and they have their own shape and size. Okay, so the next point says the cells are similar in their basic structure. Basic structure same hota hai, function bhi same hota hai, but cells are not identical. Sare cell ek jaise nahi dikhte hain. Theek hai, jo cell hamare brain mein present hai, it will look different. Jo cell hamare muscles mein present hai, they will look different. जो हमारे ब्लड में प्रेजेंट है, दैट सेल विल लुक डिफरेंट. ओके, दो द बेसिक फंक्शन इज सेम, व्हाट इज द बेसिक फंक्शन, इट हेल्प्स इन द रेस्पिरेशन, इट हेल्प्स इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, सो ऑल अदर फंक्शंस आर सेम, बेसिक फंक्शन इज सेम, लेकिन जो उनका स्ट्रक्चर है, जो उनका पैटर्न है, द शेप, is different, shape and size is different of each and every cell. Okay, so we'll discuss about it in this topic, that is variation in shapes and sizes. So we are going to discuss this topic in this point in detail in this topic. Okay, now the third point says new cells are formed due to division in old cells. Okay, now every living organism, be it human, we are also made up of one single cell. Earlier, when a fertilization process was taking place, so when egg was fusing with the sperm, so this is the single cell. Egg is a single cell. Okay, so we are also made up of single cell. When this single cell starts to divide, then a zygote is formed, then an embryo is formed, then a baby is formed. Alright, so we are also made up of a single cell. Us single cell mein jab divisions hote hain, then the human body is made. And same is the case with animals and plants also. All the living things, like basically I am here talking about multicellular organisms. So all the multicellular organisms are made up of initially a single cell. Hamesha wo ek single cell se bante hain. Okay? Now, so I think this third point is clear. Children, if you are not, if these points are not clear to you, you can ask in the group anytime. Okay? When the portal is open, you can ask your doubt. Okay? Now, coming on to the fourth point, the organization of cells in the body of living organism determines its structure. कैसे सेल्स ऑर्गेनाइज्ड हैं बॉडी में वो उसका स्ट्रक्चर डिफाइन करता है. लाइक द सेल ऑफ लिवर सेल, लिवर में एवरीबॉडी नो व्हाट इज लिवर, लिवर का शेप अलग होता है. यस, स्टमक का शेप अलग होता है. इवन लीव द ऑर्गन्स, इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स एंड ह्यूमंस, दे आर ऑल्सो हैविंग डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ शेप्स. So, जैसे सेल अरेंज होते हैं वैसे उनका शेप हो जाता है. ओके, सो दिस इज द थर्ड फोर्थ पॉइंट. द वे एन ऑर्गेनिज्म फंक्शंस डिपेंड्स ऑन द वे द सेल वर्क्स. सो द वे वी आर परफॉर्मिंग इज, वी आर नॉट परफॉर्मिंग, आवर सेल इज परफॉर्मिंग लाइक दैट. ओके, सो एवरी फंक्शन दैट वी आर डूइंग एक्चुअली आवर सेल इज परफॉर्मिंग दैट फंक्शन. ओके, so these are the five points of cell theory which was given by Sladen and Swan in year 1838. Okay, so you should remember this. Getting it? So all these living cells are made up of cell wall. So I think these points are clear. Please read these points once. If there is any confusion, please do ask me. Okay, in the group. Now coming on to next topic, that is unicellular and multicellular. Children, we have already discussed it in the previous classes. What is unicellular and what is multicellular? So what is uni? Uni means one. Cellular means cell. There are several organisms that are made up of only single cell. Okay? Though that single cell is performing all the functions. That single cell will help in the digestion also, in the movement, in the growth, in the reproduction and giving out of the, like all the function that the cell is performing, wo ek single cell wo sare function perform karega, lekin us organism mein wahi ek single cell present hoga. Like for example, amoeba, paramecium, euglena, all these are what? They are unicellular organisms. What are multicellular organisms? Like plants and animals, those have millions and billions and trillions of cells. They are multicellular. Multi ka matlab hota hai many. Cell, cellular means cell. So they are having many cells. Okay? So that is called multicellular organisms. Getting it? Now we know that cell, we are made up of cell. So cell when combines together, it forms tissues. Tissues when combined together form organ. organ when combined together it form organ system and hence a complete organism is formed. So let's see, I'll show you the diagram here. So see, organisms are of two types, unicellular, multicellular. Organisms that have only single cell are called unicellular. Organism consisting of many cells are called multicellular. So amoeba, bacteria, paramecium are unicellular. Plants and animals are multicellular. Okay. Now this is the cellular organism. Children, we have studied that atom is the smallest unit. Yes. अब आपको atom और cell में confusion होगा. तो इसलिए दिस इज द डायग्राम. सो सी, स्मॉलेस्ट इज एटम. एटम कंबाइंस टुगेदर टू फॉर्म मॉलिक्यूल. नाउ दिस फॉर्म्स अ सेल. ओके, नाउ द सेल व्हेन कंबाइंस टुगेदर इट फॉर्म्स टिश्यूज. टिश्यूज व्हेन कंबाइंड टुगेदर इट फॉर्म्स ऑर्गन. ऑर्गन लाइक एनीथिंग, स्टमक, लीवर, एवरीथिंग. दे आर देन अरेंज्ड टुगेदर इन एन ऑर्गन सिस्टम एंड व्हेन दीज ऑर्गन सिस्टम्स आर कंबाइंड टुगेदर they form a complete organism. This is called a cellular organization. Getting it? So this was the basic thing that we have studied today in this chapter. So we have talked about the discovery of the cell, we have seen unicellular, multicellular organism, we have studied about cell theory. Okay, so children, please go through these topics that I have taught you today, so that if you come across any kind of doubt, you can ask in the group. Okay, so that's all for today's class. Today's homework is to read this chapter, read first 2-3 pages so that the concept becomes clear. Okay, so that's all for today's class, children. Thank you and Jai Hind everyone.